Hey guys, how's it going? Today, brought to present you brand new Chinese car 2016, and this is gonna be full in depth tour of this Chinese car. Set up, show the engine, show you a bunch of interesting features inside and out. And so, here's the key. Let's start the engine, let it run for a while. Also, this car does come equipped with a smart key access system. Right now, the car is unlocked. The lock. Press this button, chrome door handles and turn lock, press it once again. Very simple. Nice. Three spoke design steering wheel, very solid doors, nice looking interior, sophisticated dashboard, not bad. Nice. In order to start the engine, put your foot on the brake and then hit button start. Very nice setup. Good looking interior. Alright guys, let's turn headlight, rear fog light, high beam, sole headrest lights. And right now guys, let's take a good look at the exterior of this car. Roof rails up top, chrome accent window frames, your deck light spoiler with LED third brake light, rear defrosting glass, rear wiper. Beautiful LED tail lights, very nice looking. Glass plate lights right there. Rear fog lights, tail hook, single exhaust. And from the back, it looks like Audi Q5. Multi-spoke aluminum wheels, 17-inch, tires measuring 235-65, 4-wheel. Ventilated disc brakes, beautiful factory rims. LED. There's some of his exterior mirrors, very bright, huge mirrors, good visibility. Heated windshield wipers, this area. Halogen projector headlamps. Headlight washers, as you can see. For the optional fog lights, chrome grille. This car has inline 4, 16 valve, dual head cam, 1.5 liter turbocharged engine. It produces 162 horsepower and 215 Nm of torque. Maximum speed 180 km per hour. 0-60 time is 9.8 seconds. Combined fuel consumption for this car is around 8.5 liter per 100 kilometer. The car is front wheel drive and the fuel tank is around 60 liters. Independent McPherson Strut suspension with anti-roll bar up front and independent Multilink suspension out back. Alright guys, right now, take a good look at the exterior of this car. Let's take a good look at the interior portion, the most interesting part. Alright guys, it's raining outside as you can see. I'm gonna show you the interior of this car. Awesome. This car has two airbags, smart key access system of course. Absolutely incredible Chinese car. Here's the key. As you can see, lock and lock, trunk button. Sweet. Aftermarket alarm, of course, with remote start. Nice. You notice that the engine, put your foot on the clutch. As you can see, and then hit a button start. Very nice startup. This car comes equipped with hydraulic assist by steering, you can in. Very fluid steering wheel. Nice. Grips up top, as you can see, fake aluminum inserts. Airbag right here. Manual tilt and telescopic. I'm sorry, manual tilt only. As you can see, very convenient. And the issue. Outside temperature, and of course warning, parking brake, seatbelt, and digital clock up top. As you can see, trip information, average and current fuel economy right now. It's not correct actually, it's not accurate right now. Easy to read gauges. Alright guys, your bar mirrors, they also heated of course. Nice. Huge mirrors, by the way. Central lock right here. Bar windows. Nice. Back windows. Fully tinted, as you can see. Nice. Bar window lock. Sweet. Soft leather wrap armrest, wide stitching, rich wood trim, very elegant handles. As you can see, speakers. This car has 8 speakers. Speakers up top, and your hanging speakers down there. Storage area, cup holder, and your bottle holder right there. Of course, your glove compartment for the driver, turn off the electronic stability program and panel gen. Overall build quality and all the materials in this car are just incredible. Hard touch, good sound isolation, my 6'3" stature. This car feels incredible. Legroom is more than enough, thigh support is pretty good, and shoulder room is okay. Nice. Everything is very nice put together here. It's unbelievable, you can definitely feel this true Chinese quality. And here's your light and indicator controls and your wiper controls, including a rear wiper. Nice. Alright guys, right now, let's see what kind of noise this engine produces. Very smooth engine. Very nice sound. Nice. That's for the additional airbags, as you can see right there. And of course, available power moonroof. This car missing power moonroof. Manual adjustment rear view mirror. Nice. Engine start and stop button right there. Rich switch room. Very interesting vents, as you can see, and bad audio. 8 speakers, like I mentioned before. 4 tweeters, sweet. The different modes, mute. Select between different track or select between different station. Band, the different settings, USB integration, 6 customizable stations, volume. Nice. Good audio quality. Not bad. Not bad indeed. Down here you'll find your very easy climate control, your temperature. Air conditioning on and off, your different modes, facing, etc., front rear defrost. And a fan speed control. Recycle settings. Nice. Rich wood trim. Cigarette lighter and ashtray right there. 5-speed silky smooth manual transmission. Reverse. Once again. Reverse. First, second, third, fourth, and fifth. Rear light shifter. Front trim, 2 convenient cup holders, rear light e-brake, wrap, white stitching, very good. sunglass containers, also fed, of course, your headlights, them light right there. Nice. Of course, your warning right here. Vanity mirror, no illumination at all, and your grip handles up top. Good visibility. Overall, this car feels amazing for its price. Cheap to buy, cheap to run, very nice quality. Nice, definitely. For its price, just Chinese bargain, that's for sure. Nice one, definitely. Not bad, not bad indeed. Alright guys, let's shut her down. Let's grab the key and continue our tour. Fuel cap release right here. Manual adjustment for the driver's seat, seat high, recline, sliding right there, seats are quite comfortable, adjustable headrests of course, and your tire pressure right here. Sensitive brakes, very interesting steering, your fuel cap, holder right there, nice. Second row. Child safety locks right there, same materials, carryover as you can see. Back seats easy default, 60-40 split as you can see. Chest anchors right here, completely flat to increase more cargo, space. Adjustable headrests of course. Nice, quite easy to get in and out by 63 stage, not bad. Solid doors. Of course, storage pocket right there and right there. Legroom is not an issue at all, and my headroom is pretty good. Little ashtray, completely flat floor, storage area. Nice. Grip handles up top, yeah, cut hook. Of course, your central armrest, soft seat cup holders, and ISOFIX system. Hooders right there. Very good back visibility, and your main speakers right here. Nice. Actually, this car looks like VW Touareg or Tiguan. Not bad. Exquisite interior. By the way, quite comfortable rear seats, quite soft. Alright guys, let's check trunk space, shall we? Surprisingly, trunk is huge. As you can see, your cargo cover, cargo tie-downs, your trunk illumination, and down here you can find your tools. It's really kind of hard to do it with one hand. Alright. Full-size spare tire, warning triangle, and jack. Nice. Good size trunk. Smart key access system, and you can find same manual adjustment for the passenger seat minus seat height. Not bad. Emblem, as you can see right there. Glove box is not lockable. Damp, deep, good size half box. Very nicely equipped Chinese car for its price, quite reliable. Feels very solid. Well guys, hope you enjoy my in-depth look at this 2016 brand new Chinese car. Thanks for watching and take care guys. It's raining outside.